Yesterday she had wished in secret for a box of caramels, and instantly found the box beside her. Today she had saved her daily wish in case she might need it in an emergency, and the time had now come when she must use the wish to enable her to escape with her friends from the prison in which Ugu had caught them. So, without telling anyone what she intended to do, for she had only used the wish once and could not be certain how powerful the magic belt might be, Dorothy closed her right eye and wiggled her left big toe and drew a long breath and wished with all her might. The next moment, the room began to revolve again as slowly as before, and by degrees they all slid to the side wall and down the wall to the floor, all but Scraps, who was so astonished that she still clung to the chandelier. When the big hall was in its proper position again, and the others stood firmly upon the floor of it, they looked far up the dome and saw the Patchwork Girl swinging from the chandelier. "Good gracious!" cried Dorothy. "However will you get down?"
"Won't the room keep turning?" asked Scraps.
"I hope not. I believe it has stopped for good," said Princess Dorothy.
"Then stand from under so you won't get hurt," shouted the Patchwork Girl,
and as soon as they had obeyed the request, she let go the chandelier and came tumbling down, heels overhead, and twisting and turning in a very exciting manner.
Plump!
She fell on the tile floor, and they ran to her and rolled her and patted her into shape again. End of chapter 22.
Chapter 23. The Defiance of Ugu the Shoemaker.